Good morning, children. Welcome back to online classes. So, previous class we have discussed about the Indian's location and physical futures. Let me revise all those things whatever we discussed in the previous class. Then I will continue the lesson. Now, tell me, children, how many physical features we have? How many physical features are there? Yes, we have the six physical features. Will you name them? Yes, the Himalayan ranges, Thar desert, Indo-Gangetic plains, very good, peninsular region, then coastal plains, and finally is the island of India. So, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Where it is Andaman and Nicobar Island? Which side, children? West or east? Yes, it's the east side. Yes. So, in the Andaman and Nicobar, how many islands are inhabited? Tell me, children, how many islands are inhabited? Very good. 36 islands are inhabited. Very good. And what about the Lakshadweep island? How many islands are inhabited? Tell me, children. In the Lakshadweep, yes, the 10 islands are inhabited. What is the meaning of inhabited? Where the people live. Very good. So, these all things we have discussed in the previous class, children. You know, in the today's class, you are going to learn about the Indian rivers and climate. So, children, in this lesson, you will learn river. So, in that river, there is a, according to that, they divided to the two groups. According to their flow, they divided to the two groups. First is the perennial and the non-perennial that we are discussing. And the next we are discussing about the climate, about the season. So these three topics we are going to discuss in this lesson. So today's class we will see only about the rivers. Yana children. So river. Rivers are a major source of fresh water. Rivers are a major source of fresh water. Yes. So, and it have been sites of great civilizations. There is a numbers of civilizations are there. We not only have the fresh water, we also have the sea, salty waters also. You know, children? So, India has a varieties, vast varieties of landforms. And therefore, India rivers are categorized on the basis of the landform. So, on the basis of Indian rivers are divided into the two part. Later we will discuss that. Okay, children. So, where the small rivers and stream, when they join, they make the tributaries. So, first you understand the meaning of tributaries. What is the meaning of tributaries? Okay, children. Where the small river and the stream, small river and stream join. They join together and they form a tributaries. Small rivers, see the small rivers, they join and they form a tributaries. tributaries. Don't confuse. Okay, children. So before joining this river and stream, before joining to form a tributaries, they divided into the. The dividing is what they break into the small rivers or stream. These rivers before join, they divided. Now see, for example, see here, one river is flowing from here and another river is flowing from here. Before joining this both rivers, what happens here? This A and this B river. Think it is the Ganga and this is the Brahmaputra. Before joining this both rivers, before merging this both rivers, they break into the small streams here. And that is called the distributaries. See, they break into the small rivers, and this small river is called this breaking. Before merging, when they divide, when they break into the small river, this is called the distributaries. What is called? This is called the distributaries. Okay, children, this I given the example. Clear? Now here you can see, before, see, this is small river and the stream, they join and they form a tributary, they form a big. But before joining this both the river and the stream, before merging this both river and stream, they break into the divided into the many small river and stream, and that is called what is there? Breaking into the small river and stream, and that part is called the distributaries. What is called? Distributaries. Clear, children? So don't confuse. Tributaries are different and distributaries are different. Okay, this is the break into the small river, and here river and stream, they join and they form a tributaries. Clear, children? So the land area drained, by a river and its tributary that form a river basin. What do they form? They form a river basin. So according to that only, the river are divided into the two part. First one is the perennial river and another one is the non-perennial river. So first we'll understand what is the meaning of perennial and non-perennial. So perennial means what? So this clear, my children? Tributaries means what? Tributaries means what? When the small river and stream join together and they form a tributaries. What is the distributaries? Before merge this river, they divided into the small stream and the pond. And that small stream and the pond is called the distributaries. So river are perennial and the non-perennial. River are perennial, okay? Perennial and non-perennial, two types are there, okay, children? So river are perennial. First we'll understand what is the meaning of perennial river. Perennial river means what? Which flows continuously. Okay, children? continuously throughout the year, which flows continuously throughout the year, those rivers are called the perennial river, which flows continuously. Okay, children, continuous they flows throughout the year. That rivers are called the perennial river. Okay, children, the next is that the non-perennial river. Non-perennial river means what? Non-perennial river. So what is the meaning of non-perennial river? Non-perennial river means what? Which depends upon the rain water. In this, the rivers are depend upon the rain water. Those rivers are called the non-perennial rivers. It's depend upon rain water. Perennial, non-perennial river are also called the seasonal river. What they call? They also call the seasonal river. Why it is seasonal river? Because when the rain comes, then only these rivers fill with water. Otherwise, rest of season, in the winter season, in the summer season, these rivers are dry. There is no water at all. So, because of that, these non-perennial rivers are also called the seasonal river. Clear, children? See, rivers are perennial and non-perennial rivers. So what is the meaning of perennial here? Which rivers flows continuously throughout the year? Those are called the perennial river. Non-perennial, which these rivers are depend upon the rain water, is called the non-perennial river. These non-perennial rivers are also called the seasonal river. Now we'll see in both which rivers comes. Okay, children. Rivers can be classified on the basis of their origin, where it is the birthplace, where the river is a starting point. So, on the basis of their origins, rivers are divided. Rivers are divided into the Himalayan rivers and the peninsular rivers. So what is the two types? First one is the Himalayan rivers and next one is the peninsular rivers. Okay, children. So Himalayan rivers means what? What is the meaning of Himalayan rivers? Himalayan rivers, which rivers originate in the Himalayan ranges? See here. So which river originate in the Himalayan ranges, which flows the continuously place, now you will think, now all the rivers' original place is Himalayan only. No, not all the rivers are originate here. Not a birthplace of all the rivers are here only. Okay? So only which rivers, they start from, or the birthplace, or they start here, their original place is here only. Those rivers only flows continuously. Why? Because we know it that this area is covered with the snow only. How the snow is melting, they will get the water. They will get the water throughout here. They will get the water continuously. Clear, children? So in this, in the Himalayan rivers, we can see the Indus River, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These three rivers are originated in the Himalayan. They originated in the Himalayan only. Clear, children? Which river? Indus. Then Ganga and Brahmaputra. Indus, Ganga, and then Brahmaputra. So these three rivers, they start from the Himalayas. Okay, children? The snow-fed river of Himalayas, the snow-fed river. I have shown, no, see here, this is the snow-fed river. Snow-fed rivers of the Himalayas are perennial. Why it is called the perennial? Because it flows the continuous snow-fed. The snow-fed rivers. Why it is snow-fed rivers, children? Because Himalaya, as you can see, this area, it is covered with the snow only. So how the snow melts? Slowly, slowly, these rivers get the water continuously. So it is called the snow-fed river of the Himalayas. Are perennial. So this river is also called the perennials. Starting only I told, perennial rivers means what? Which flows the continuously. Okay, children, the three major river of the Himalayas are Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These all three rivers, they originated in Himalayas only. Later we discuss detail. Okay, children? So clear, these are the three major rivers. These are the three major rivers are in the Himalayas. The Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. Now we see the next one. What is that? Peninsular rivers. The peninsular river is what? The rain-fed rivers. What is that? The rain-fed rivers. Rain-fed rivers. Rain-fed rivers of the Deccan Plateaus are non-perennial rivers. Rain-fed rivers means what? They depend upon the other water, they depend upon the rain water, they depend upon the other stream. Clear, children? That is called the rain-fed. Rain-fed depend upon the rain water. Depend upon the rain waters are non-perennial river and have an uncertain flow. Uncertain means what? It is not a continuously. In this river, they won't get the continuous water. Uncertain flow. When the rain comes, this river will fill with water, rain water. You know, if in the next year, suppose this year, if there is no rain, then this river will go up dry. Here and there we can see the some of the waters. You know? So, peninsula rivers are rain-fed rivers. Rain-fed river of the Deccan Plateaus are non-perennial and have an uncertain flow. Have the uncertain flow, not a continuous, because it's depend upon the rainwater. So in this, the major rivers, the major rivers are divided into the two types. The rivers are divided into the two types. One side it is the eastern flowing river and another side is the western flowing river. So these rivers, these peninsula rivers are divided into the two types. They divided into the two types. First one is what here? First one is the eastern flowing river. East flowing river. And another one is the west flowing river. West flowing river. See, we have the eastern coastal area and the western coastal area. So they divided according to their only two types. So the major peninsula rivers are divided to the two types. First is the western flowing river and another side is the eastern flowing river. This is the west flowing river. Okay, children. And another side is the east flowing river. So in the east flowing river we can see the Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari and Kaveri. In the west flowing river we can see the Narmada, Tapi and the Sabarmati. Clear children? So don't confuse in that second one, peninsula river only. This region, the peninsula, the major peninsula rivers are divided into the two types. First is the east flowing river and the another side is the west flowing river. Clear children? Yes children, so peninsula rivers are divided into the two types, east flowing river and west flowing river. So in the east flowing we can see the Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari and Kaveri. And in the west flowing river we can see the Narmada, Tapti and Sabarmati. So these are the types of peninsula river. So on the map you can see here, see the top, which rivers are originated in the Himalayas. Those are called the Himalayan regions. They flow continuously. So in that comes Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. They are called the snow-fed rivers. What they call? They call the snow-fed river. Snow-fed river. They get the continuous water and is also called the peninsular river. Clear students? This all the things, Indus, Ganga and the Brahmaputra, later we will discuss detail. What is the origin place, how they flow and what are the tributaries, distributaries, everything we will learn very detail. Clear children? So in the today's class, what we discussed about the rivers. Children, we discussed about the tributaries, distributaries and we discussed about the rivers are perennial and non-perennial. and the rivers are divided into the on the basis of origins, they divided into the two part. First one is the Himalayan rivers and another one is the perennial rivers. Clear children? So let me revise whatever I finished in this video, then same thing I will continue in the next session. So tributaries means what children here? Tell me, what is the meaning of tributaries? When the small river and stream join together and they form a big river, that is called the tributaries. So what is the tributaries? What is the meaning of tributaries? When this river and stream before a river merge, it's break into the small streams and rivers, and that are called tributaries. Clear children? These rivers mostly break into the small streams and rivers. That is called the tributaries. Clear? What is the meaning of peninsular river? Which rivers flow continuously? Those are called peninsula. North peninsula, they depend upon the rain water, and also it is called the seasonal river. And the last we discussed, on the basis of origin, there are the two types, Himalayan ranges and the peninsular river. The major peninsular river are divided into the two parts, that is the east flowing and the west flowing river. So next class children, we will discuss very detailed how this Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari, Tapi, etc. rivers are originated and what are their tributaries and distributaries. This all the things we discussed very detailed in the next class children. So here, what is your work children? What is your work? You have to draw the map. Previous video also I had given the homework, same. Draw the map and then mark the physical features. Yes. So this time I will change. So this homework you have to do in the social part only, children. So map I given in previous video, no? So this time I will change. Okay. Homework. Unscramble the name of the river. Unscramble name of the rivers. So first one, Ganges. So this words is not correct order, so you have to arrange it correctly and then write here. Okay, then next one, Y U A A M. Third one, M A D H double A N I. AA, 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 A students, you have to arrange correctly and then write in front. Clear? So this work you have to do in the social part only. What is the homework? Today's homework: unscrambles name of the rivers. So arrange it correctly. This all the letters and make a one river name. Okay, children. So these things you have to write in the social part, not in the ABS part. Write the lesson name Unit 5 India and write the second lesson Indian Rivers and Climate, and then do the work. Don't take the help of your parents. It's a very easy. Do it yourself only. Thank you, children.